the story of the Johnson twins as like each other as two young kids. Who was born? His self-same death. How long was kept? How long even away? And did you ever hear how the Johnsons died? Never knowing that they shared one name. To the day they died, when a mother cried, "My own dear son's life slave."
I'm sorry, love, but by the ear up to ear behind up stories, if you pay today, I'm cutting your deliveries.
I said, look, I'll pay you next week.
Next week? Next week? I'll be a rich woman if next week ever pay.
I said, look, I'll pay you next week. I've got myself a little job and money will come in, and I'll be able to pay you. You can't stop the milk. I need the milk. I'm pregnant.
Well, I'm sorry, but don't look to me. No money, no milk.
Mum, where's milk?
Mum, the baby's crying, there's no food in. Where's all the bloody food?
Don't swear! I've told you! I know it's hard on you kids, but try and get some sleep.
Hi, Mrs. Johnson, how are you? How's the job treating you?
It's great, thank you. It's a lovely house. It's a pleasure to clean it.
I know. It's a pretty house, isn't it? Quite a bit rather large and pleasant.
Mr. Lyons has been away and that. When does he come back, Mr. Lyons?
Well, the company sent him out for 9 months, so he'll be back in about 5 months' time.
Ah, I bet he'll be happy when he's home. The house won't feel so empty then, will it?
Well, actually, Mrs. Jane, we bought such a large house for the children. We thought children would arrive.
Ah, well, we might still be able to.
No, I'm afraid not. My husband and I wanted to adopt, but my husband wanted a child of his own. I myself think that an adopted child would be one's own.
Ow! It's weird though, isn't it? It's you! You can't have kids, and me, can't stop having them. My husband used to say that all you have to do is shake hands with me and I'll be in a club. He must have shook hands with me before he left.
I'm having another one, you know.
Oh.
Oh, but don't worry, Mrs. Lyons. Having babies is like clockwork for me. I'm on my feet and working out today. Hey, if I have this one on the weekend, I won't even know you to take a day off. Jesus Christ, Mrs. Lyons! What are you doing?
Oh my God, what?
The shoes!
Pardon?
New shoes on the table, take them off. Oh, Jesus Christ, Mrs. Lyons, you never put new shoes on the table. You never know what will happen.
You mean you're superstitious?
No, you just don't put new shoes on the table.
Go on with you, but to make sure any better, I'll put them away.
And a joke note in the pack. The salt's been spilled, and the looking glass is cracked. There's one lone magpie overhead.
I'm not superstitious.
The mother said.
I'm not superstitious.
The mother said.
And I've gone into medicine.
I'm your midwife, Mum. Now, should we listen to the baby's ticker?
I was dead worried about having another baby, no doctor.
I didn't see how we were going to manage with another man to feed. But I got myself a little job and I think we'll be able to get by even with another man to feed.
Mouths, Mummy. Mouths.
What?
Hello, Mr. Johnson. You're having twins. Congratulations. And the next one, please, nurse.
Quickly, an idea planted, contained, and grown from the plan. The thought conceived in his very
British corpses.
When are you due?
Well, he said...
Oh, but Mrs.
Come on, quickly, tell me when you do.
July, he said the beginning of
July.
And my husband isn't due back until...
middle of July.
He may never guess.
Oh, it's mad.
It is mad. It's wonderful. It's perfect. Look, you're what, 4 months pregnant and just beginning to show? So...
I could be 4 months pregnant and just beginning to show. You said yourself, you've got too many children already, Mrs. Johnston.
Yeah, but I don't know if I want to give one away.
Already you're being threatened by the welfare people, Mrs. Johnston.
Surely with another two, how could you possibly avoid one of them being put into care? Surely if you give one to me, it'll be better.
You'll be able to see him every day, as long as you came to work.
Are you that desperate to have a baby?
I would still be able to see him every day, wouldn't I?
Of course.
And you would look after him, wouldn't you?
Of course. Now look, help me. I need to watch you walk, buy clothes and bottles and suffer from pies.
What?
Doesn't one suffer from piles? We're on to cricket.
Look, you must help me. Is it in the right place? I want it to look right before I go shopping.
What are you going to the shops for? I do the shopping.
No, Mrs. Johnson. From now on, I do it. I want everyone to know about my baby.
Mrs. Johnson, now we must make this a binding agreement.
In the name of Jesus, the thing's done. Now there's no going back. It's too late now. The feeling's torn. There's a path to the sin and do.
Why do we have to do that?
Because nobody has ever known about this, Mrs. Johnson. Therefore, we have to make an agreement. Right, I'm off to the shops. See you next time.
I'm sorry, love. The kids did stay at the hospital.
Oh, look at them. They're lovely, aren't they?
I'm so sorry to have to do this at a time like this, but you're just 12 weeks behind your panic is not good enough. Look, you know that you shouldn't sign for stuff if you can't afford it.
I know I shouldn't, but when you go into the showrooms, everything looks so nice, and in the catalogue it says you've got 6 months to pay, and that seems like years away, and you need a few things, so just sign.
Well, you shouldn't bloody sign then, should you?
I know I shouldn't. I spent my whole bloody life knowing I shouldn't, you soft twat. Now leave the TV and get off!
Look, love, you know, honestly, I am sorry.
It's all right, lads. Get used to it now. One time, we sat down for dinner and they came to collect the table.
Well, you know, at least you can laugh about it, eh?
Yeah. They're born. You didn't notify me.
Well, I thought, couldn't I just keep them for a few more days? They're a pair, they're going together.
My husband
is due back tomorrow, Mrs. Johnson. I must have my baby.
We made an agreement.
You swore and by them.
Well, you better decide which one you want then.
I'll
No! Don't tell me! Just take it!
Thank you so much, Mrs. Johnson. I really am. I'll see you next week.
I'm due back tomorrow.
Why don't you have the rest of the week off? I'll still pay, of course.
Where's the other twin, Mum?
What happened to the other twin, Mum?
He's died, son. He's gone up to heaven.
What's he like?
With Jesus and the angels now.
Yeah. What's he like up there, Mum, in heaven?
Ah, he's lovely, son. He'll be well looked after there.
Will he have his own bike?
Yeah, with both wheels on.
Why can't I have a bike, eh?
I'll look in the catalogue when I get home.
But I want an air pistol, Mum.
You said I can have a new dress, Mum.
Let's look in the catalogue now.
Let's have a look in the catalogue.
It's away from me looking in the catalogue, Mum.
I said I'll look in it when I get home. I've got to go to work.
Yes, I'm rather proud of Jennifer too, aren't I, Edward?
Oh, he's lovely. Look, he's going to cry. Just pick him up.
No! No, Mrs. Johnson.
But he looks like he's going to cry.
If anyone shall pick him up, I shall pick him up. All right?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh,
yeah. Jennifer, don't be hard on a woman. She's just playing with the baby. That's what women like to do, isn't it?
No, I don't want her to hold the baby. I don't want the baby to catch anything. Babies catch things very easily.
Well, you know best, Jennifer.
You don't see her as much as I do, Richard. She's always fussing and cooing over the baby, as if she was his mother. She ignores most of her work now, and I think she should go.
Well, what will you do to help around the house?
Well, I'll find someone who won't spend all day fussing over the baby.
All right, you know best. The house is your domain, after all.
Richard, can I borrow some cash?
Of course.
I'll need about £2,000.
My God, woman, what for?
For the baby and for the nursery.
Oh, all right, Jennifer, you know best. Look, I've got to go to work for an hour. I must dash off to a board meeting.
Mrs. Johnston?
Yes?
Would you come here a minute, please? Richard and I have been thinking, and we have suggested you left work. Does your work? Your work is deteriorated.
But our work have always worked.
Well, we're just not satisfied.
But what am I going to do without any money?
We've thought about this, and here. I know it's a lot of money, but...
Okay. All right, Mrs. Lyons. If I'm going, I'll take the other baby with me.
No, Edward is my son. Mine.
I'll tell the police. I'll ruin the place.
Do you not realise how much of a crime you've committed? You sold your baby. You'll be locked up.
I didn't. You told me to. You said I'd be able to see him every day.
I'll tell someone.
No, you won't.
You won't tell no one, Mrs. Johnston. Because you know what they say about twins secretly separated at birth, don't you?
What?
They say that if either twin learns that they were once a pair, they shall both immediately die. This means, Mrs. Johnston, that these twins shall grow up unaware of each other's existence. So if you tell anyone, Mrs. Johnston, you'll kill them.
Without arms or legs or even heads, and in the bath when he goes swimming. But
I'm not allowed to go in the baths because I'm only 7 and my mum says I might get drowned, but I'm not. I'm nearly 8.
You know what, Sammy? Joey sometimes does. He wheezed in the house next door to us straight through the letterbox.
I tried to do it one night, but I had to stand on my crate, but I still can't reach it.
But I will by the time I'm 8.
Richard, it's Edward. don't want Edward Grant away from his father.
Daddy, how do you spell bogeyman?
Ask Mummy, darling. I've got to go to his board meeting.
Mummy, how do you spell bogeyman? How do you spell bogeyman? I'm trying to look this up. Is he gonna get me?
Oh, Edward, I told you he's not real.
Alright, does Eddie live here?
Mickey!
Alright, Eddie! Oh, I've got Sammy's car park outside. You wanna come out and play?
Oh, isn't he fantastic, Mum?
Do you go to the same school as Ed?
No. Right, come on, let's go!
Okay,
Edward, get in the house, it's bedtime.
Come on, Mummy, it's early!
Where did you meet that boy?
In hell.
And his second name is Johnston, isn't it?
Yeah, and I think you're very mean.
What have I told you about hanging around with boys like him?
But he's my friend, and I like him more than you.
Don't ever say that! Don't ever say that! I'm doing this because I love you!
Well, if you love me, let me be friends with him!
Never want you hang around him again! I'm frightened! Missed!
Right, that's it. We're not playing with the gun no more.
Oh, why?
Because it gets broke if you use it too much.
What are we supposed to do now then?
I don't know.
I know what we can do. Let's throw stones through that window.
I dare you, Linda. I dare you.
Well, I'll do it because I'm not scared. Are you Eddie? Look, Eddie's scared.
No, Eddie's not scared, are you, Eddie?
All right then. On the count of three, we all throw together.
All right.
One,
two, three.
Your mother caught a flea. She put it in her teapot to make a cup of tea. And what the hell do you think you're doing?
Waiting for the night to bark.
He's not with us.
Sir?
Sir?
No, he's definitely with us. What's your name, son?
I've got it now.
Countryside, do you think you'd like that?
No, I want to stay.
What do you think about it, old chap?
Hello, Mrs. Johnson, how are you?
You what?
How are you?
Oh, sorry, I ain't used to kids inquiring about me, Elf. I'm very well, Master Irons. How about you?
I'm very well, thank you.
Yeah, yeah, look it. Does your mother look after you?
Of course.
I've told you, Eddie, not to come round here again.
I know, it's just, I want you to see Nicky.
No, it's Bessie.
I'm moving away to the country tomorrow.
Lucky you.
But I don't want to go. I want to stay.
Why is that? When are you going? Tomorrow. Oh. We really won't see you again, will we? What's that?
I don't want to go. I want to stay here, where Mickey is.
Now come on, Eddie. Don't you be soft. I bet you're loving your new house and you'll make loads of new friends. And you'll forget Mickey ever existed.
No, I don't want to forget.
Shh. Look, there's you. You don't want to go with me. I spent years trying to get out of this place. We're a right pair, ain't we, me and you?
Well, why didn't you get a house near our fit?
Just like that?
Yeah.
Hey, do you want a picture to remember Mickey by?
Yes, please.
Look, there's Eddie, Mickey, when he was younger.
And is that you?
Yeah.
Are you sure I can have this?
Yeah, but let's keep that secret between me and you, yeah? What are you looking at?
Well, I didn't think you liked me at first, but I think you're smashing.
What about the girls when you start dancing?
Pardon?
Nothing.
Mickey! Say goodbye to Eddie, he's moving!
Thank you.
Mum.
Mickey, hurry up! You're gonna be late, you're gonna miss the bus!
I'm not!
Well, you're gonna miss the bus!
I won't!
Well, you missed Linda.
Well, what do I see her for?
Well, you've only been speaking about her in your sleep for like the last week.
You liar!
Oh, my sweet darling!
Why, come off it, have a lie down the school play!
Okay, I believe you. Now, go on, get the bus. You might miss it.
Hiya, Mickey!
Oh, is that what you're waiting for? For Mummy to give you a boost on you?
I'm going, I'm going.
Wait, wait for me, you. Where are you going, Sammy? The dog. Try, lads, be good. I'll cook you a nice surprise when you get home.
All right, Todd's turn for me, mate.
How old are you?
14, we both are. A child return for me as well, please.
Son for me?
No, son.
What?
Sammy. You're older than 14.
No, I'm not.
Well, Sammy, just turn me 16. I'll give you the rest of the fare. Ain't a problem, mate.
You know the penalties for trying to defraud.
Defraud? I ain't defrauding no one!
Looks like I'm going to the cop shop now.
Look, open your bag and give it to me now!
Sammy, stop it! It's not too late!
I said give it to me! Mickey, come on!
You stay where you are, Mickey. You've done nothing wrong.
Mickey! He's staying here!
He'll get put away for this, you know.
I know.
He's always been a soft git, your Sammy.
I know.
You better not do anything soft like him.
I wouldn't.
Or I wouldn't be in love with you anymore.
You're always saying that.
No, I'm not.
You bloody old told me in assembly yesterday.
Well, I was only telling you.
Oh, yeah, this 500 lot as well, yeah. Look, we're off now, lazy ears. Come on.
Getting rather big for your boots, are we, Lions?
No, miss.
No, miss? Yes, miss. I think you're a bit of a tight Lions. The boys in your dorms say you wear a locket around your neck. Is that so?
Yes, miss.
A locket? A locket? This is a boys' school, Lions.
I am a boy, miss.
Well, then you must stop behaving like one. Now, hand me over this locket.
I shall not tonight. You can take a flying fuck out of Roland Dahl, but you shall not take my locket.
You are suspended!
Yes, miss.
And now we know, don't we, that the Bora engines of the Amazon live on a diet of what?
What?
They live on a diet of what?
I don't know.
Of what, Johnston? They live on a diet of what?
I don't know.
You don't know? You don't know? I just told you 2 minutes ago, lad.
Leave him alone.
Oh, look, this, you started this, it's got nothing to do with you. It's Johnston, not you.
Thanks, Mark, I'm not listening, you aren't you?
We're not listening. I just told you 2 minutes ago.
Yeah, I am.
Oh, what? They can't be in front of the class then?
Yeah, alright.
Okay then, so the Bora engines live on a diet of what?
Fish fingers.
Shut up! Shut up, the lot of you! How the hell do you think you're ever going to get a job when you never listen to anything?
It's boring, isn't it?
Oh, it's boring. Oh, it may be boring, but you won't be saying that and you can't get yourself a job, will
you? Oh, yeah. No one wants some solid pygmies in Africa for their dinner's really going to get me a job, isn't it?
Oh, shut up!
I was going to go work in an Elfie Gun restaurant.
Oh, get out, Johnston! Get out! Take no notice, Mickey, I love you. Johnston, out!
Leave him alone, will you, big worm?
Oh, you and all, get out!
I'm just going, I'm going.
Go on then. You're both suspended.
Suspended? Because of the locket.
Because I wouldn't give her my locket.
But what so? Can I see this locket?
I suppose so. If you want to.
Where did you get this from?
I can't tell you. It's a secret.
It's from a girlfriend, isn't it? Is there a picture in here?
Yes, Mum. Can I have it back now?
Oh, you won't let Mummy see your girlfriend. Is she beautiful?
Yes, Mum. Can I?
Oh, let me look at it.
Mummy, what's wrong?
When were you photographed with this woman?
Pardon?
Tell me, Edward, when?
Oh, Mummy, you silly old thing, that's not me. That's Mickey and his mum. I never looked a thing like Mickey when I was little.
It's just... Why do you wear it? Where did you get it from?
I can't tell you. It's a secret.
But I'm your mother!
I know, and it's a secret. Everyone has secrets. I bet you even have a secret.
You didn't
didn't tell me it was going to be over a load of fields.
Well, I didn't tell you nothing. You followed me.
Mickey! Mickey, I'm stuck! Honest, look, my foot's stuck!
What have you done? Look, let me grab your arms. Your arms, look. Come here.
No. I think you'd be more successful if you were to put your hands in.
Stop it. You're not attacking the mic out of me.
No, I'm not!
Here, look, you can see the estate from up here.
Have you brought us all this way to look at a bleeding estate? Mickey, we're 14!
Well, look, there's that lad who always hangs out the window.
Him! He's good looking, isn't he, him?
What?
He's gorgeous looking, isn't he?
Well, right, you told me once.
Well, what are you going up thinking of the fact fella's gorgeous, eh?
I don't.
Oh, Mickey Johnson, give up on you. You've got me bleeding nerves.
Linda, where are you going? Linda! I just want to tell you that I love you and I want to hug you and kiss you.
Well, between you and me, we fornicated over. You didn't hear that from me.
I just don't know the words.
Here's a ciggy.
I don't smoke, actually, but I can get you some if you like.
Are you soft? A blood brother!
Well, shag the vicar, Mickey.
Funny saying in that posh voice.
What posh voice?
Oh, so do you live up there?
And you live?
Yeah, up there.
And that girl you was with, was that?
Linda. Yeah.
And she your girlfriend?
Yeah, well, she's one of them.
One of them? It means you have more than one girlfriend.
Don't suppose you share one with me.
Eddie, mate, I've only got one girlfriend.
But you said Linda.
I know, but she would be if I just never had the words. I don't know what to say.
Well, you mustn't let them. It's easy. I've read all about it, you know. Next time you see her, you look her straight into the eyes and say, Linda, I love you. My loins are burning for you. The very core of my being is longing for you. And you look over to her eyes and maybe a bit close, and her voice is somewhat husky, and she says, Be gentle with me! It's work, you know, I've read all about it.
Yeah, but what if, well, maybe we can see first hand, you know, the graphic film, isn't it? 50 Shades of Grey, right?
Yeah, we can go see.
Yeah, well, I'll have to go get some money.
Oh, I've got plenty
of money. No, honestly.
We'll go and see my mum, alright? Go and live down, bro, come on. Alright, Mum. Look who it is. It's Eddie. Can I borrow a tenner?
Yes, sir. In his fireballs.
Alright, cheers.
Hello, Mrs. Johnson. You're looking well.
Am I?
Do you still keep that? Yes, of course. Look.
Is it alright if I bring Eddie back for a cup of tea or something later?
Yeah, go on then. You go and enjoy yourselves, but hey, don't be too late.
We won't.
The Lego.
Oh, Gravity's Lego house. Do you see it?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's funny. When I drove past Oakley this morning, they're playing 50 Shades of Grey.
It's a double bill. Double bill, yeah.
Oh, a double bill of BQ's amazing spectrum of colours. Do you really think I've worn it today?
No.
Oh, she's smashing your mum.
Fucking head case, not she is.
Hello?
How long have you lived here?
A few years.
So you always going to follow me?
I follow anybody. I was 3 hours here.
Don't
I? I know what you're doing to me. You gave him that locket, didn't you? Well, I thought I wouldn't need him to have something to remember me by, even though he'd never know.
Afraid he might have eventually forgotten you.
No, there's no chance of that. When we moved, he started to talk less and less of you and your family.
I came to believe that he was actually mine.
He is yours!
No!
I took him, but I never made him mine.
Does he know?
Of course not.
Even when he was a tiny baby, I see a stay.
Tits! 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 Tits!
Calm down, you head case! Give it
a look! What do you think you're doing, son?
Adolf Hitler?
I suggest you get down from there.
Waiting
for the 92 bus! Hey, look, I think someone's broken into your car.
Oh, God!
Guess who? Merry Christmas, Mickey!
Yeah.
Mickey, what's the matter?
Nothing. How's university?
Oh, it's absolutely brilliant. I've never been to so many parties in my life, and I've met so many new friends. You'll meet them at the Christmas party, you know. I'd draw the doll and say, screw you, and live like a bohemian. What's the matter with a job? Anyway, I've got money, plenty of it.
I don't want your money, alright? I'm not a bohemian. I don't wear a hat or I can tip at the world. I'd love to be standing in your shoes right now, telling me the same thing, but I'm not in your shoes. I'm in mine, alright? Eddie, do me a favour, mate. Get me away. Get away from me right now. Get away before I hit you!
Linda!
Mickey!
love.
Hello, Eddie.
Why have you come to see me?
I heard you had new friends. I didn't know about him.
I always push my friends aside just so I can see you.
Look, Mickey, I'm offering. Come on, all I'm asking for you is keep an eye out for me. Look, they've got nothing. Look at that. You're just like me, man. Come on, where are you taking your title for New Year? Nowhere.
Well, as I don't think I'll probably want to see you again, I've always loved you.
I suppose I've always loved you in a way.
Then marry me!
Didn't Mickey tell you? We got married 2 weeks before you came home, and I'm having a baby.
Look, we don't use shooters, they're just frighteners. Look, come on, all I'm asking for you to do is just keep an eye out for me. You ain't even going to be where the action is. Come on, Mickey!
I'm sorry, Linda.
Look, a grand, Mickey, a grand! Think of everything you could buy with money like that. Come on!
4 grand?
Yes!
All right.
Great, but cheer up, Wilda. There's no year.
Well, have a good New Year, Eddie, and I'll see you soon, yeah?
Happy New Year, Linda.
Linda, get your stuff on. We're going out.
Where?
We're just going to go out. Fanciest restaurant in town. I've got loads of money coming in. Don't worry about a thing.
From where, Mickey?
Look, just someone I know. It's fine. It's going to be all right, okay? Look, they're already waiting for me. I've really got to go. Okay?
Mickey!
All right, Sam.
Is that our Sammy?
Look, I love him.
Mickey, no!
I've got to go.
Give it to me! Give it to me now what you're doing! You're doing really nice if you get hit with one of them. You won't give back up. This isn't just children's games.
Oh my God, you shot him.
I know I bloody shot him.
Oh, you shot him.
I know I have. Look, I've got to get this kid quick.
Sammy, you shot him.
Oh my God.
I can't deal with this. Just leave me alone. Just leave.